today my friend Frankie is going to be reading a passage out of Lord of the Flies by William Golding, which is a banned book. It's about a group of young boys who are stranded on an island and forced to learn how to live on their own without adults. It was published in 1954, and then in the 70s, 80s, and 90s was challenged and banned across America in different places. It was mostly banned for violence, putting self before others, and discrimination against minorities, women, God, and people with disabilities. It's still challenged a lot today in the U.S., but is also required reading in a lot of schools.
Now Jack was yelling too, and Ralph could no longer make himself heard. Jack had backed right against the tribe, and they were a solid mass of menace that bristled through the spears. The intention of the charge was forming among them. They were working up to it, and the neck would be swept clear. Ralph stood facing them, a little to one side, his spear ready. But by him stood Piggy, still holding out the talisman, the fragile, shining beauty of the shell. The storm of sound beat at them, an inclination of hatred. High over overhead, Roger, with a sense of delirious abandonment, leaned all of his weight on the lever. Ralph heard the great rock before he saw it. He was aware of the jolt of the earth that came to him through the soles of his feet and the breaking sound of stones at the top of the cliff. Then the monstrous red thing bounded across the neck, and he flung himself flat while the tribe shrieked. The rock struck Piggy at a glancing blow from the chin to the knee. The conch exploded into a thousand life fragments and ceased to exist. Piggy, saying nothing, with no time from even a grunt, traveled through the air sideways from the rock, turning over as he went. The rock bounded twice and was lost in the forest. Piggy fell 40 feet and landed on his back across the red square rock in the sea. His head opened and stuff came out and turned red. Piggy's arms and legs twitched a bit like a pig's after it had been killed. The sea breathed again in a long, slow sigh, and the water boiled white, pink, all over the rock. When it went, sucking back again, the body of Piggy was gone. Ralph's lips formed a word, but no sound came.